You know, one of our investors always tells me that humans are really bad at understanding exponential growth. And he gave me this example of if you took a piece of paper, right, and folded it on itself 50 times, how tall would it be? Have any of you guys heard this before? It's pretty interesting. I mean, how tall do you think it would be? Most people would say it's like, you know, a few feet, right? I mean, that's 50 times, that's a lot. It turns out it goes to the moon and back more than 10 times, which is, I mean, it's kind of interesting, just like your intuition around how these exponential functions grow, because it's 2 to the 50 times whatever the height of a piece of paper is, right? So it's a very small base, doubling many times, and it ends up being extreme. Now, of course, you can never do this, right? Because, I mean, you can not fold a piece of paper, but in theory, it's pretty interesting. And if you look at, you know, where Facebook is, and we think that this trend of people sharing at an exponential rate every year is not just a Facebook phenomenon. It's probably an internet phenomenon. We can just measure what we see on our service. That it's growing at a much faster rate than user growth is, right? So, it was reported we hit 750 million users. We did. The reason why we didn't report it is because we don't think it's the metric to watch anymore, but we did. We have 750 million users now, and it's still growing quickly. But the thing that's growing even faster is the amount of sharing per person, right? So this isn't aggregate sharing across the network, because that's actually growing at a faster rate than this, because in addition to the amount that each person is sharing, the overall size of the network is also growing at a very quick rate. But if you just looked at the amount of stuff that each person was sharing, it's growing incredibly quickly. Now, these exponential curves, because they grow so quickly, you don't tend to look at them like this because they just go off the chart too quickly. So you tend to look at them in what we call a log normalized graph, right? So that way, if you look at the y-axis here, it's skewed, right? So it's not going up linearly. This is kind of how people tend to look at these exponential graphs to plot out how progress is being made over time. And the most famous one that we have in the technology industry is Moore's Law, right? Where Intel famously, after a few years of observing this trend, predicted and saw that the number of transistors that you could put on an integrated circuit doubled just about every 18 months or so, and that would continue. And they used that to drive all of these all these industry trends, right? They figured, okay, well, if this is going to keep on growing at this rate, then that means that 18 months from now or 36 months from now, we're going to need to be able to support these types of apps that are really intense. And in order to do that, we're going to need to be able to fit this many transistors onto an integrated circuit. And in order to do that, we're going to need wires that are 16 nanometers, so we better start researching copper now, right? And there were these interesting trends like that. And we kind of see our own growth and the growth of the social ecosystem following a pretty similar trend, right? So if you look at how sharing has grown, you can kind of plot this out into the future and say, okay, well, if this is what people are sharing now, then what types of things are people going to have to be doing, or what types of apps are going to have to exist 3 or 5 years from now in order to make it so that this trend can continue, because we believe that it will. And we believe that, you know, if you look at where the site started off, I don't know how many of you guys remember Facebook in 2004. There wasn't that much to do. I mean, you could, like, update some interests on your profile, right? So not a surprise that the graph starts off with people sharing around 0.1 things a day, right, on average. And then, you know, as the site went on, we made it so people could share more stuff. There's this feedback loop. People wanted to share more stuff, which is why we built those products. Originally, stuff like photos, that was way before mobile photos, so mostly people were uploading big albums. They did that maybe once every few weeks on average, increased the amount of stuff that was being shared. Then things like newsfeed increased the rate of flow through the whole site, so people were sharing more stuff and consuming more stuff. Platform obviously made it so that there was a whole wave of new type of sharing that could happen. Then, you know, you introduce lighter weight ways for people to share stuff, like the like button, ways for people to segment their audiences, like groups, which have been really successful, which we'll get into in a second, lighter weight messages. And we just think that this is going to keep going. So this is the next 5 years, I think. If you look at this not on a log normalized graph, but on the exponential graph, it's right, we're at like the elbow of the curve. I mean, we're at an extremely interesting point for the world in this evolution. And the stuff that's going to get built in the next 2 years is going to be built on top of the infrastructure that we've built. And it's just, I mean, all the apps that you use are going to be very dramatically different. So I don't know. This is what I'm excited about. This is what we've kind of been hard at work building for the last 6 months. We have a lot of stuff along this theme over the next few months that we're getting ready to roll out. And we have a few things that we want to talk about today. So now this is where we are today. We have 4 billion things on aggregator shared every day. So that's just kind of a bit of narrative for just to put all the stuff that we're going to do into context. Now, the stuff that we're doing today actually doesn't even play into the 4 billion at all. This is more like public type things that are being shared, not individual messages. Today we're going to talk about some